Hey guys, it's me, Mr. 250, and welcome back to Tales of Zestiria. We last left off, what the heck did we do? We did something, but I can't remember right off. Anyway, I've been told pretty much we're good to go for the ending. The only other thing I might want to do, which I think I will, I don't think this will take too long video-wise, is to get the Mithril gear. Which I've been told means we have to get every shop up to level 3. Which involves, you know, things like buying, selling, and whatnot. Now, let's see if there's... Is there a way to tell what level the shop that we're at is? Oh, the stars, of course. So this shop, for example, is at level 4. I'm hoping, without actually having to physically travel around everywhere, there'll be a way for me to tell what shops are which level. Let me see if I can do that. Well, I can tell you this. An item shop has to be rank 3 or higher for us to order items. Which means all these are at least level 3. So I would want to look for what isn't level 3. Alright, I believe I've finally done it. As noted by this guy being quest here. I've followed every lead on Mithril that I could. But it seems that the mines are exhausted and all reserves are long since used up. In other words, we brothers have no means of obtaining this ore. However, there is one thing we learned. Our father once made an attempt at digging up Mithril in a roundite forest. I imagine that he had some reason for doing that. It would seem worth looking into. Please take this. It's the tool our father used for mining expeditions.
If we can just obtain some Mithril, we could have weapons and armor made from it.
Right you are. So, yeah, that's where we're heading now. Yes, and this is it. There we go.
Yes! Mithril is ours, baby!
Let's take it to the weaponsmith in Logren.
And apparently this really small sample that we took is, I guess, going to be able to get us weapons in the future? Or something like that? I don't really know. This is indeed Mithril. As promised, we will work together as brothers to outfit you with Mithril equipment. It is time to reveal to the world the secret art we inherited from our late father, Milton. Or Milton. Our very hearts have been... Sorry, you're thinking... There you go. Our very hearts have been worked into this equipment of Mithril. It is my hope that it shall help you on your journey. Alright, so... Consumed it. Did we get anything? I don't think so. Also, I got this from the cat corner. Anyway, from what I've heard, it actually isn't something you get right off. It just gets you... Yeah, it just gets you the ability to buy it from places. Which is kind of dumb, but it does. And you have to go to different places to actually get, you know, the different pieces. And as one other thing, I pretty much had to sell most of the things that I owned in order to finish getting the shops up to level 3. Because rank 3 is not the same as, like, 3 stars. So, that I had to sell a lot of stuff to get to that point. So I don't think I'll quite be getting Mithril quite yet. Anyway, we're gonna move on to the main focus of today's episode. I don't know how long that took. I don't think it'll take too long when I cut it down. But, let's see. Yeah, right here. We're actually gonna go to the Origin Village. I've been told that this is gonna take some time, and there's a point of no return that we'll hit later, but not quite yet. It'll be pretty obvious, I've been told, and that's where we are going to start streaming from. But I figure we might as well proceed in the story, since we haven't done that in, like, forever. Maybe fight
You're
some dudes.
Run away?
We'll be gone! Ready?
I need money.
Sword flare! Red darkness! Down! Whoa! Yeah!
I command!
Yeah! Burn! Red darkness! Alright!
Go!
ready? Let's keep it up!
I command! Burrowing dragon!
Sweet dreams!
Sweeping dragon!
Lord of wind!
Fear the storm!
Be gone!
Soul Sight! Gale-fed.
Yeah! Tiger Blade! Let's keep it up!
Well...
What's that?
Man, it's a rock. I like rocks. Camlin's founding monument. The monument in Camlin.
This stone monument looks pretty new.
It says something here. Let this be the beginning.
A monument commemorating the establishment of Camlin?
The beginning of what, I wonder? Michael had just quit being a shepherd.
The beginning of a normal life with his family, I suspect.
And also, maybe, the first step toward a world without malevolence.
So Camlon's name, the Origin Village, it probably didn't initially mean the origin of the Age of Chaos.
He meant it to instill hope.
Michael.
There's still a chance, Lila. We can make Camlon the origin of hope again.
By bringing a close to the Age of Chaos.
Indeed.
Yeah, we gotta stop the chaos.
The malevolence is getting stronger and stronger. Are you guys doing all right?
Oh yeah, doing great.
You don't have to worry about us. We're fine.
Oh, okay then.
Yeah, just worry about yourself.
See, they can't escape. This is great. Good technique.
Appear, flames!
Calamity, flames!
Appear, flames!
The best technique.
Calamity, flames!
You might feel a
appear,
slight
flames!
Note.
Shield me! Burrowing Calamity, flare! Flames! Sweeping dragon!
Just overwhelm the enemy with the exact same spammy move over and over again.
If you're putting your life on the line, then you'd better give it your all.
We got Primeval Crown. Crown forged with metal no longer obtainable, imbued with defensive qualities. See if that's any good. We wouldn't have quite as much attack by a decent chunk. That increases defense by a lot, though. Increases BG by 1. Reduces magic attack? Ugh. I guess this is more for defense. I don't know about this. See, if it only decreases physical attack, I might be able to get behind that, but that decreases a lot. Hi, turtles. Dark Turtles Emporium. You selling cool mithril stuff? No? I don't know about you guys, but this place seems spooky to me. Norman? Where are you? It says you're right here. Hiding in the house.
This place was in the Celestial Record.
What, a burnt down house? That was in the record? I have no equipment to use this on. I cannot claim him. Oh, that's funny. Okay, let me go buy just something. Oh, wait a second. Does that a circlet not have any room or something? I know we just got that. That crown? Can we not put anything else in the crown? I don't even know. Let's try that. That's weird. Burnt remains of the Shepherd Michael's home. There we go. Another Norman down.
Oh, hey, we saw this before in the Earthen Historia.
Michael's house. And you slipped here too, right?
Yeah, I guess that means I was here myself as a human baby.
So that makes Camlon your hometown, huh?
It's yours as well, isn't it?
I suppose. But I don't feel anything toward it.
It's just one of those historical technicalities.
I can't think of my hometown as anywhere but Elysia.
Yeah, same.
You and me. Elysians now and forever.
Now and forever.
Preventi. I didn't even see what he did. I just needed something to put it on so we could get him. All damage taken reduced by 30? Oh man. I definitely should have put that on something better. Oh well. Oh hey, look. Just a giant evil thing.
Rise and rage, Flint! Sword flare! Let the go! Burn! Don't push yourself, Lila!
Lightning Tiger Blade!
Gonna feel the burn!
Nope! Alpha Blade! Radiant Beam! Hang on, everyone!
Freeze, Flint!
You look particularly evil and slightly optional.
Let's do this.
Okay, let me just carve through these enemies first and then we'll deal with them.
You act on instinct, wait.
Yeah, you look pretty evil. I like fighting evil things. Evil things have money. And I like money.
Now this'll be
weak to physical. You look evil. Although you don't have Giganto Monster music, which is weird.
Tiger Blade! What a formidable opponent!
There you go. I got an imbued orb for that. What was that? That was crazy. You want to talk about that? I guess not. So what all we get from that? That was kind of weird. The only dagger capable of being fused with any other dagger. However, its base power will never improve. That looks pretty good. 2x damage on 10th, 30th, 20th, and 30th hit. Oh. But its base power never improves. So we would lose a massive amount of attack power, defense, a little bit of defense, and a decent amount of magic attack. For the option of doubling our damage upon long combos. And we can fuse it with other daggers, I'm assuming, to increase the other stats, maybe? That is a weird, weird dagger. I don't know how I feel about that. We also got an imbued orb. This orb will evolve into a blessing orb given enough centuries. Boost everyone's max HP. Oh man, that's weird. I like it. So I guess he was kind of just like an optional boss. He just didn't have the Giganto Monster music. Man, they just got, like, dudes just sitting everywhere.
We can't hold
it's
back.
Odin. It's weak to arts.
We'll be gone. Raging wind. Three become one.
Is this hair supposed to, like, freak out like that whenever we do this? Or just, like, starts flicking around? You see that?
Destroy. Swarm the sky.
Selfistia.
The Spear of Gunther!
Feel
the
burn!
Shake it up! Hear this wind! Beast
Feather! Magnetic Field! What is this?
Splendid job, Sarai!
Let's keep it up!
Wow, that was rough. I got through it, but I had to keep calling down the Beast Thunder move, which is actually really good at canceling out him trying to do a super move on me. Or he had this really big area of effect move that was kind of annoying. Sword to unify all ritual swords, however its base parameters will never improve. So I would take a huge damage hit from that. Is there really a reason to use that? I mean, I get the idea is you can combine it with other swords, but its base stats never improve. So will it ever actually get better? Kaiser Road. Like, I get what they're trying to do, but does it actually do anything? What's this? I got a new move, apparently. Oh, like, that's gonna happen. Let's see. Does anyone want this? Oh, that would increase damage by a lot. I would take a big defense hit, though. Oh, man, but that's so nice sounding, isn't it? Sure, I'll be squishy as can be, but I'll actually do some decent damage. I don't mind being a glass cannon. As long as you know how to aim it. Let's see. They seem to have a lot of, like, high-risk, high-reward weapons down here. Like that, he would get an awful lot, like a huge, like almost doubling of magic damage while taking nearly the same hit from physical damage. But he does do a lot of magic damage, so I think that would still be a good thing. I'm assuming that's where we're supposed to go. What's up? What's over here? Oh. Ah, there we go.
Is that a monolith?
We're gonna learn something right at the end of the game. Difficulty, intense, and chaos. Friends may weep openly or faint. What does that mean? What does that mean? Is that a joke? It was highlighted in green like it meant something important. Yeah, these enemies down here are kind of brutal. Even just like normal field enemies, which I guess makes sense. You know, it's the super evil land of evilness and all. But talk about evil. Talk about evil. This place looks super evil. Oh, man. Look, there's whirlwinds of evil. There's, of course, malevolence hanging in there. Can't forget that. There's the dark skies of death. Which, isn't this below? I mean, where the heck is this? Isn't this below Elysia? Like, how does this just not exist anywhere that we could see? There's floating evil rocks. We got evil floating platforms. We got evil down below. Lots of evil. I like evil. Good evil. Bad evil. Super evil.
The amount of malevolence here is just crazy. If Saray wasn't here, we'd all be dragons by now.
Is Maltellus emitting it, or is it flowing into Maltellus? In either case, the malevolence here is definitely what turned Maltellus into a Hellion.
The heart of the malevolence seems to be in the back of the village, and there we should find...
Heldulf and Maltellus.
Let's go! The Hellions in this region are incredibly strong. You must be careful.
I will. You guys do the same.
We got this. Never underestimate the Shepherd's posse.
Like a blank page.
So I found this sketchy looking equipment.
Sketchy?
Oh, the one I was talking about.
From Wright as a merchant, if you really think so.
You're lecturing me about the ways of a merchant?
It's true that its name, appearance, and capabilities are all kind of wonky. But you can fuse it with the same types of equipment.
But that's expensive, isn't it?
You might think so. But the cost of fusion will be offered at its lowest price ever. Soon this wonky piece of equipment will be a household item.
So it is actually wonky?
Plus, get this. If you fuse it 10 times and then hand it over to the Lord of the Land, guess what happens?
the Lord of the Land will provide you, and only you, with a free blessing!
Isn't that the same as with any other equipment?
Is that a thing? I didn't know that was a thing, even with normal equipment. I don't know.
Ugh, so much malevolence. It's way worse than the last time we fought Heldolf.
It just means we're getting closer and closer to him.
Yeah, we can't afford to let our guards down.
Yeah, this place looks evil. How much money do I have? Just out of curiosity. A decent amount.
Man, this ain't even fair.
I'll take on this cute-looking succubus.
But she's a powerful opponent with few weaknesses.
True. She's weak to physical.
We've come this far. We can't lose yet. Be gone! No escape! It's over!
All right. You ready?
Ready? Strike! Hang on, everyone!
Hey, sweetie.
Stay with me.
Ready? Strike! It's over! Please,
Ben!
Dragon, hang on, everyone!
I love Zavini, such a great character.
You guys hanging in there?
Yeah, definitely gonna go for the Mithril equipment soon. I just wanna... I'll probably need some more money before I can really do it.
Let's get him!
It's a tiger hellion which attacks Seraphim in the dark.
Don't try to face him one-on-one. Good luck.
Great circle!
Freezing strike!
Magnetic field!
Hear
the storm! Hear the storm! Not yet!
Healing circle!
Tiger blade! Earth dragon bang!
Fear
not yet! Blade bang! I won't lose!
Dragon
forger! Hear the storm! Tiger blade! Soul drain! Alright! Meatball is scattered! Yeah! Burn! Rend the darkness! Hang on, everyone!
Ready for dirty dance!
Tiger blade! This isn't over! It went hit! This isn't over!
Red freezing blue!
Hail
and tandem!
Sword flare! The dazzle flash! Rise and rage, flames! Sword flare! Rend the darkness!
Multiple current!
Sweet dreams!
Hold my enemy! May your knowledge be from you!
Yeah! Sword flare! Rend the darkness! Rise and rage, flames!
Feel the burn!
Flash!
Bring in heat!
Entering Crimson!
Ready for dirty dancing?
Tiger blade! Rest it out!
I still got...
You know, thinking about it, I don't really know if I want to delve into this yet. My main concern with going through with today's episode was to just kind of finish up with some of the last little bits of stuff we had left to do. And I think I've pretty... I thought about it. I don't really think I want to go ahead and go through that yet. My main goal for today was to knock out kind of the last few things before the ending. Because I was told it was going to be probably about 3 or so hours till the end from where I'm at. And I didn't quite want to do a full 3-hour stream at once. That's not where I meant to go. So I figured I'd do a little bit of it now. And then we can do a stream soon. I'm not sure right off when I'm gonna do this stream. What is today? Today is Sunday. Maybe Tuesday. I might be able to work out Tuesday for myself. Yeah, unless things change, we're probably gonna go for Tuesday at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Like I said, unless things change. Buy some Mithril stuff. That's all he's got? Just earrings? I just want to see the stat difference on that. So I had these. These did give me a higher magic attack, but a lower magic defense. But that's just one piece. I know I could get like a whole list of equipment, to my understanding. Anyway, yeah, I'll stop here. If there's anything else, kind of last minute, you got Mithril. Oh man.
A weapon of Mithril. I can feel its immense power just holding it in my hand.
Does seem like a bit of a waste, though. You do realize how much that sells for, right?
I think this right here is a better investment.
Weapons symbolize the spirit of adventure. So you're a real man after all, Sheps.
Spirit of adventure?
Huh? Was I off? What do you mean, then?
Just... this is something we were only able to obtain because we traveled to every corner of the world. So this weapon is one of the answers our journey led us to.
Oh, I get it.
Ugh, I should have known. You're still an incorrigible choir boy.
You should be grateful, Zavid. If he'd been following your example, they'd have chucked all the Mithril into the ocean for the good of humanity.
Undoubtedly.
Yeah, like I was saying, if there's anything else that I should be going for, let me know. Maybe I'll travel around and get a few pieces of Mithril equipment before we start during the stream next time. But yeah, that's going to be all for now. Anyway, thank you guys for watching, and unless I say differently, expect to stream at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on Tuesday. Yeah. Although technically I could do it a little bit earlier in the day, because I have that day off. If anyone really wants it earlier in the day, we could. I don't know, let me know. If I don't say anything else, expect 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. But I could be convinced otherwise. Anyway, thanks for watching. Bye. Maybe I'll do a little bit more. I took a break for a bit, and see, I'm kind of at the... I want to get the Mithril armor, but I'm pretty sure to get to it, I'm going to need more money, which I could get by fighting these monsters. So maybe we'll go for a little bit longer. See if I can find another save point or something.
Please, Edna!
Just see what's beyond this. Oh boy. This looks particularly evil. So I'm gonna guess I can't go this way yet. Until I get to the other side and burn that, and then that's like a shortcut back, I bet. So we do have to go the other way.
Let's get this over with.
All right, yeah, let's try this way then. Looks a little bit more hospitable. That's the word I'm looking for. Aqua Interrupter. An umbrella so water repellent it makes you wonder if it's on a mission to destroy the very rain itself. And an hourglass. This doesn't lead much of anywhere, does it? That is not doing things that I want it to be doing.
Let's get this over.
These aren't like destructible walls or anything, are they? Nah. I didn't figure so. So that would mean this isn't the right way to go either. I think. Because I can't set that on fire, I can't jump that jump. Was there a third pathway up here that I missed? Yeah, there is one that goes straight on. That's probably what we want.
Yeah.
Alright, so let's try straight on. I didn't figure it was going to be that simple. I thought we'd have to take a side route to unlock the straight on route. I mean, maybe we still do. Oh god, this looks confusing. Oh, actually, it's not as bad. Just the mini-map looks scary. I will say this. I think this map is kind of big.
It said that Garudas possess godlike levels of mana.
And it can totally fly, too, so we better watch it.
A lot of enemies would just... They do a decent amount of damage, but they have a lot of health. Which I guess isn't necessarily a bad thing. Considering how well I've been doing recently. And all those anomalous orbs I've got have buffed the crap out of me, so... I probably do need something to keep it interesting. And this looks familiar. I do remember being told that there was going to be a section where we had kind of like a boss rush sequence, which this with flame, if we're starting out with an easy flame puzzle, definitely feels that way. I am liking the architecture here. It's got a little bit of modularity, but it's not like too bad. You look like bad news. Alright, let's go.
Now this'll be a good time.
What are you? He's weak to water. Seems to have a lot of defense on him. Like he's now not taking that much damage.
Let's keep it up! Sword rain!
I am enjoying the more difficult bosses, though. I noticed with the other two bosses, I'm not sure how much of the video I'm going to keep in, just because I did fail more than once. But as you get to the end of their life, they employ much more difficult battle strategies.
Tough?
Well, I expected it.
You guys gonna fight? Ooh, a fight!
Gonna charge you admission if you
want. And I assume we're gonna have even more of those. One for each tower, or each dungeon, so to speak. Trial, whatever you call it. I don't know. Yeah, we'll just stop right here. This is the hallway right afterwards. I don't really want to go too much farther, but I didn't want to play just a tiny bit more, I don't know. Anyway, we will continue from here next time. Thanks for watching. Bye!